kwa maafa hayo. Rachel Mwigai, KTN News, katika kaunti ya Nyeri.
Mtazamaji, Rais Uhuru Kenyatta anatarajiwa wakati wote kuzindua mpango wa kusambazwa kwa vitabu vya mtaala mpya. Shughuli hiyo inahudhuriwa na washikadau katika sekta ya elimu wakiwemo wachapishaji vitabu na pia waziri wa elimu Daktari Fred Matiang'i. Hebu ni kupeleka kule moja kwa moja.
After basic education, that is from primary to secondary, our youth will be able to have several pathways. Those who get, for example, a C+, as you see the arrow on the left-hand side, will directly go for the bachelor's degree. Now, those ones who get a C- and a C+ will have an opportunity to go into the diploma programs. Those who get the D plane and D plus will be able to go into craft training. And those who get E and D minus will be able to get into the artisan programs. Now, as you can see though, with those arrows, depending on ability and willingness, our youth can walk through right up to the highest level. We have also the skills center option, where those, for example, who may not make it through primary or after standard 8, they may opt to go for national skills to train in a particular discipline, which is a singular skill area. Remember, we have had in the past the government treaters grade 3, grade 2, grade 1. But in the new qualifications framework, we have increased proficiency in that area so that one can move in from National Skills Certificate 3 to 2 to 1, then go to Master Craftsperson Grade 3 up to the top, Master Craftsperson 1. And at that level, as you can see, an individual who has specialized to that level can actually will be operating at the level of postgraduate diploma, so that there's room for all Kenyans. And this system, Your Excellency, caters for all. And the Kenya National Qualifications Authority, as a national authority for standards and qualifications, caters for everyone in the sector from basic to higher levels. And on our council seat, for example, the quality assurance agencies. At the basic level, we have the Directorate for Quality and Standards in the Ministry. At the tertiary level, we have the TVETA, Technical Vocational Education Training Authority, and then at the university level, we have the Commission for University Education. We also have professional bodies represented. We have COTU, we have FKIE, because we believe that in the right qualifications, all must participate, the providers of education and training and the consumers of our products. And we have benchmarked all this with the rest of the international community. Thank you, Your Excellency.
Thank you, sir. Finally, on presentations, I'll request the chair, Kenya Institute of Curriculum Development, to take us through the next level. Daktari.
Mr. President, sir, students in the university discussing history of education, one of the questions they would be given to discuss would go something like this. Educational development in Kenya has been propelled by political expediency rather than deliberate educational planning. Discuss. I think that students answering this question from 2013 would answer it in a different manner. And this is because we have been given not only the time and the space to exercise our mandate. And this has allowed us to be very rigorous. It has allowed us to be evidence-based. It has allowed us to be consultative. When we are talking about the curriculum reform that has enabled us to present to you the competency-based curriculum, we have followed all the key and major steps of curriculum reform. And that is why we are confident that during your tenure, the curriculum reform you will present to the nation will be not only have been meticulously planned, but we are also taking the right steps to ensure that it will be well executed. I'd therefore like to ask our CEO, Dr. Juan, to come and take you through the steps that we have been doing in the Kenya Institute of Curriculum Development. Thank you.
Thank you, Your Excellency, Cabinet Secretaries. I'll not spend so much time except for the highlights on the curriculum reform. One thing that I want to mention here is that the curriculum designs and instructional materials are the part of the books that you'll be presenting. We have had training of teachers, and the stakeholder engagement has been going on for the last 2 years and is still going on. On this slide, two things that I wanted to mention, because people have been asking, what exactly are we changing from and what are we going into? There are many factors, but allow me to highlight the issue of values, ethics, and citizenship. When you talk of citizenship, we are talking of identity. Who are we as Kenyans? How do we relate with others? How do we coexist within our geographical space? We also feel that it's critical to give learners what we call a flexible curriculum, so that if somebody wants to become a runner, all we need to do as they go up is to enhance their entrepreneurship skills, their communication skills, and how they can relate with others internationally. They will be happy and they'll make a living. This needs to be embedded within our education system, unlike what it is now. Now, on this slide, just three things that I wanted to mention which are critical is that we are embedding pre-primary education within the basic education curriculum, because this is covered in the law, and we needed to do that. So when a child moves from pre-primary school to primary one, they don't get a shock into the kind of learning that they go through. We have also created three pathways that each learner will need to go to at high school or senior secondary in terms of their ability. If somebody is a sports person, how do we cater for it within the school? If somebody is going to technical training, how have we prepared them in terms of attitude change so that by the time they're finishing their schooling and going into technical institutes, we don't have a situation where scholarships are announced for technical training and we don't have enough students because of attitude. So that needs to change within the school. And finally, we have catered for special needs, which government has been putting a lot of emphasis on. We have those who will be integrated within the normal education system, but we also know that some are a bit severe, and those who are severe are catered for within the education system. That needed to be captured clearly within our framework. Now, we have made proposals. We started our pilot last year, and we got very good feedback, but we feel that this year we needed to continue for the pilot in grade 1 and 2 so that the issues that we identified, the gaps that we identified can be well captured and grounded before we go for the full rollout. So we are proposing that we continue for this year for grade 1 and 2 with a pilot in the whole country, both private and public, so that come next year we are able to roll out something that every Kenyan has appreciated. So, as indicated here, the green line shows how the rollout will take place. One thing that we have taken care of is that because this is a paradigm shift, we are moving into more technical skills, we don't want to hurry the process. We don't want a situation because you cannot gamble with the children's lives in terms of learning. Here we are explaining what we plan to do this year, and I think one critical component is the sessional paper. Being a very democratic country, there's a possibility that if we don't cover this, some people can run to court and claim that we have not followed the due process. So we'll be taking this through a sessional paper so that whatever we do is well anchored into the law. And we hope that come August 2018, we can have a national conference where Kenyans can be told and they agree that we are rolling out a new curriculum. This indicates the various agencies that will be involved in various bits. TSC will deal with the professional development of teachers. NEC will be developing the CB, the assessment framework. We shall be working on pre-service teacher training so that the teachers who come out of our training colleges
are aligned to the new curriculum, and we'll also proceed to develop the syllabuses for grade 4 up to 6. And finally, why we are here today is this. We went through a competitive process for the publishers who are already cleared because of the technical content. The bids were opened openly when all the publishers were there. They know what they quoted. And so by the time we released the results, I'm sure you are briefed on this, Your Excellency, we found that almost all the books, the prices that were quoted by the bidders up to the school were less by half the current prices. But I'm sure our CS will be talking more about this. Thank you very much.